Hello children, welcome to Nagesh Karasgi Orchid School channel. Now today we are going to start with the new lesson of social and political life, lesson number 7. Before going to the title, we will discuss some of the points. As we start our day, we are in need of many things. Like if we wake up, we brush our teeth, we need toothpaste, toothbrush. For taking bath, we need soap, we need clothes. For taking our lunch or breakfast, we need vegetables. We need many various things. So, from where do we get all these things? That we are going to learn today. Of course, we go to the market and purchase the things. So, let us see in this chapter, what are types of markets? Which are the types of markets? Like markets are of various types, and I am going to show you some video also, animation, so that you will understand the lesson very properly. Okay, we'll start with our video.
Markets around us. Students, let us explore the following concepts in this chapter. What is market? Types of market. Chain of markets. Market and equality. Identify these places. Supermarket, mall, neighborhood shop, weekly market. Which of these markets do you visit alone? What is the difference in the markets that you visit alone and those with parents? How are these places different from each other? Is there any difference in your visit to a weekly market and that to a mall? In this chapter, we will discuss all these questions to understand the markets around us in a better way. What is a market? A market is an environment that allows buyers and sellers to exchange goods, services, and information. Market interactions are defined by demand and supply. Invisible market transactions. Buying and selling takes place in different ways, not necessarily through shops in the market. There are market exchanges that we may not be aware of. This is because a large number of goods are bought and sold that we don't use directly. For example, a car factory purchases engine, gears, petrol tanks, axles, wheels, etc. from various other factories. Types of market. We will now view the following animation to understand the various types of markets in India, as well as the chain of markets through which products finally reach the consumer from the producer.
Father, why we have so many kinds of markets around us?
Human beings have varied needs. They fulfill their needs through shopping in different kinds of market. Do you have neem toothpaste?
Yes, we have.
I want to purchase it. How much it cost?
Only 20 rupees. Please give it to me.
Those who purchase things are buyers, and those who sell things are known as sellers. Am I right, Father?
Son, you are absolutely right.
I love to visit big shopping complexes. Why don't we go there often for shopping?
We fulfill our daily requirements through different kinds of markets. It depends on our requirement and our capacity to pay. And for that, we choose weekly market, neighborhood market, or mall.
Father, on Mondays we always go to roadside market, but on other days, where this market goes?
Weekly markets do not have permanent shops. It is held on a specific day of the week. There are thousands of such markets in India.
why we prefer weekly market.
Son, all the things we require, we get in one market. We do not need to go to different areas to purchase it. Things in weekly market are cheap. That is why we prefer weekly market.
Why things are cheaper in these markets?
Because of competition. And they do not have to pay rent, electricity bill or wages. That makes them a cheaper market.
We purchase some things from shops outside our colony gate. What kind of market it is?
These shops are neighborhood shops, and these are permanent shops near to our homes, from where we buy eatables, grocery, medicines, etc. Buyer and seller know each other, and they also provide things on credit.
What are the advantages to this market?
Neighborhood shops can be visited any day of the week. These neighborhood shops might be permanent or roadside vendor shop.
Father, let's visit this big, beautiful market. I have not visited it for a long time. And tell me something about it.
In urban areas, we find large multi-story, air-conditioned buildings with shops on different floors. These buildings are known as malls. In this market, mostly expensive branded goods are sold. Few people can afford to buy these expensive goods.
I wonder, from where do these shop owners procure their goods?
They procure goods from wholesale market. Through middlemen, goods produced in factories, farms and homes do not directly reach consumer. The people in between the producer and the final consumer are the traders. The wholesale trader first buys goods in large quantity. The trader who finally sells this to the consumer is the retailer.
I have never seen such purchases.
When consumer purchases goods, he might not be aware of the chain of markets through which these goods travel before they reach him.
Is there any other means through which we can shop?
Buying and selling takes place in different ways. Not necessarily through shops in the market. One can purchase a variety of things through phone or internet.
I have never noticed such transactions till now.
Some transactions related to purchase of raw materials often go unnoticed. We only see the final product. For example, the car in the showroom or fertilizer purchased by farmer for his crop.
Okay children, you saw the video. I think so you have understood which lesson we are going to learn today. The title of the lesson is Markets Around Us. Now open your textbook, page number C, Social and Political Life textbook, chapter number 7, Markets Around Us. So it's very simple lesson and the language is also very simple. We will read and understand the lesson. We go to the market to buy many things, vegetables, soap, toothpaste, masala, bread, rice, dal, clothes, notebooks, biscuits, etc. If we make a list of the goods that we purchase, it would be really long. There are many kinds of markets that we may visit for our everyday needs. These can include shops, hawker stalls in our neighborhood, stalls in our neighborhood, a weekly market, a large shopping complex, perhaps even a mall. In this chapter, we look at some of these markets and try to understand how the goods that are sold there reach buyers, who these buyers are, who these sellers are, and the sorts of problems they face. Now, we make a list, everyday needs, whatever things we need in our daily life. First, to purchase these things, we make a list. It will be a long list. Many things are required in our daily life. So, there are many types of markets. Some are neighborhood shops also, some are big malls or hawker stalls or weekly markets. Many markets are there. We will decide where to go and purchase. So today we are going to see about these things, and we will learn who are the buyers, sellers, who are the wholesalers, retailers, and many more things. So these are the various things given which are required in our daily routine. You can see the shops in this image. Now this is the list made here, which things we need to purchase. Now first topic is weekly market. A weekly market is so called because it is on a specific day of the week. Okay, a weekly market is, why it is called weekly market? Because in a week, on a specific day, this market runs. Weekly markets do not have permanent shops. Traders set up shops for the day and then close them up in the evening. Then they may set up at a different place the next day. There are thousands of such markets in India. People come here for their everyday requirements. Now here the shops are not permanent in weekly market. They set in the morning their shops and by evening they close them and they move to another place to set their shops. Many things in weekly markets are available at cheaper rates. This is because when shops are in permanent buildings, they incur a lot of expenditure. They have to pay rent, electricity, fees to the government. They also have to pay wages to their workers. In weekly markets, these shop owners store the things they sell at home. Most of them are helped by their family members and hence do not need to hire workers. Weekly markets also have a large number of shops selling the same goods, which means there is competition among them. If one trader were to charge a high price, people would move to another shop where the same thing may be available more cheaply, or where the buyer can bargain and bring the price down. Now here, why we prefer weekly market? There are some advantages. See, many things are at cheaper rate, okay, and they don't have permanent buildings, means their shops are temporary, they put the tents, and they don't pay rent also. But in permanent shops, they have to pay rent, they have to pay electricity bill, and they have to hire the workers and pay for them, they have to even pay for the government. But in weekly markets, this is not there. The people can set their temporary shops, and their family members only, together they work. So no need to hire the workers also. And here one more thing is, like, same type of goods are there in the market. If one person sells for a high price, the customer can go to next shop and he can take at a cheap rate, or even he can bargain for the product. One of the advantages of weekly markets is that most things you need are available at one place. Whether you want vegetables, groceries or cloth items, utensils, all of them can be found here. You do not have to go to different areas to buy different things. People also prefer going to market where they have a choice and a variety of goods. So here the advantages, I told already that weekly market, most of the things you need, they are available at one place. Okay, almost all things are available at one place. Things are at cheaper rate and people have a choice while shopping in a weekly market. Now shops in the neighborhood. We have shops in our neighborhoods where we can go and purchase the things. We have seen that weekly markets offer a variety of goods. However, we also buy things from other kinds of markets. There are many shops that sell goods and services in neighborhoods. We may buy milk from a dairy, groceries from departmental stores, stationery, edibles or medicines from other shops. Many of these are permanent shops while others are roadside stalls such as that of the vegetable hawker, the fruit vendor, the mechanic, etc. Now some shops are in our neighborhood also. It is very easy to go and purchase the things and many of these are permanent only. Those shops are permanent and while others are some roadside stalls. Some stalls are placed and vegetable hawker, they bring the vegetables on bicycles or some of the four-wheeler carts and some fruit vendors are there and even the mechanic, etc. Shops in the neighborhood are useful in many ways. How they are useful? They are near our home and we can go there on any day of the week. Usually the buyer and seller know each other and these shops also provide goods on credit. This means that you can pay for the purchases later, as we saw in Sujata's case, for example. Now we are going to read this Sujata's case. Now here the advantages are like it is near to her house and we oftenly go there. So the buyer and the seller are known to each other and even we get the benefit that we can pay the amount on credit. If we get monthly salary, monthly once we can pay and whenever we want the things we can purchase from there. Now let us see the K1 example. Sujata and Kavita were sent to buy groceries from their neighborhood shop. This was the shop they usually went to. It was crowded today. The shop owner managed shop herself with two helpers. When they managed to get into the shop, Sujata dictated a list to her. She in turn began asking her helpers to weigh and pack the items. Meanwhile, Kavita looked around. Now, Sujata and Kavita were sent to buy some groceries. Were from neighborhood shop. And this shop was run by one lady with two helpers. Now, when these two visited, the shop was crowded. But anyhow, they entered the shop. Now, here Sujata started to dictate, means she prepared the list at home and she brought it and she started to dictate the items to the owner and the owner, she is asking her helpers to weigh and pack the items. Meanwhile, Kavita was looking around. On the top left shelf, there were different brands of detergent cakes. Another shelf had toothpastes, talcum powder, shampoo, hair oil, the different brands and different colors look so attractive. On the floor lay a few sacks. Now Kavita was looking around. What she found? She found various things of different brands. There were toothpastes, talcum powder, shampoo, hair oil, soaps and many other things. And some sacks were lying on the floor also. It took almost 20 minutes it took almost 20 minutes to weigh and pack all the groceries. Then Sujata showed her notebook. The woman noted the amount of rupees 3000 in the notebook and gave it back. She also noted the amount in her big register. Then Sujata took the heavy bags out of the shop. Her family will pay for the purchases in the first week of next month. Now here you can see it took 20 minutes to purchase all the things. And Sujata, what she did? She did not pay the money, but she showed one notebook in which all the rates were mentioned of whatever she has purchased. Now even the owner also, she noted this amount. How much amount it is? 3000 rupees. She noted in her big register to keep the accountability. Now Sujata took the heavy bags, means she carried the grocery or whatever item she purchased, she went home. Her family will pay for this. When should they will pay? In the first week of next month. Maybe they are getting their salary, so they are paying, or they are getting money, they are paying in the first week of next month. Now she got on credit the items. So we saw about neighborhood shop. This was an example. You might have noticed that there are different kinds of sellers in even in the neighborhood market. Some of them have permanent shops and others sell their goods on roadside also. They sit on the roadside, they sell, and again they leave it. And but some have the permanent shops, shopping complexes and malls. Let us read this example. Anzil Mall is 5-floor shopping complex. Kavita and Sujata were enjoying going up and down in the lift. They went to the shopping complex now. It seemed as if it was made of glass and they were able to see outside as they went up and down. It was fascinating to see so many different kinds of shops, such as the ice cream, burger, pizza and other food shops, shops full of home appliances, footwear and leather items, as well as book shops. So in this complex there were many types of shops. Eatables were there, shops of home appliances were there, footwear, clothes, stationery, everything was there. So it was very fascinating to see all these things. While wandering about on the third floor, they entered a shop that was selling branded ready-made clothes. So they thought to enter one of the shop where clothes were there, they were of branded. The security guard looked at them as if he wanted to stop them, but he did not say anything. Looking at them, he felt what these people will purchase in this way. He thought, and he was trying to stop, but he did not do. They looked at some dresses and then looked at the price tag. Now they saw some of the dresses and they saw the tag. None of them was less than rupees 3000. So very expensive the clothes were. They were above 3000 only. Almost 5 times the weekly market price. Sujata whispered to Kavita, "I will take you to another shop which has good quality ready-made clothes at more reasonable prices." Now Sujata, slowly she told to Kavita that I will take you to another shop which has good quality, even though not branded, but good quality ready-made clothes at reasonable prices. Let us see of shopping complexes and malls. So far we have seen two kinds of marketplaces, weekly markets and markets in the neighborhood. There are other markets in the urban area that have many shops, popularly called shopping complexes. These days in many urban areas you also have large multi-storied air-conditioned buildings with shops on different floors, known as malls. In these urban markets you get both branded and non-branded goods, as you have read in the chapter on advertising. Now, branded goods are expensive, often promoted by advertising and claims of better quality. The companies producing these products sell them through shops in large urban markets and at times through special showrooms. As compared to non-branded goods, fewer people can afford to buy branded one also. Yes, some people, they prefer to buy branded clothes or whatever the items. So, these are placed in big shops and big malls. Here, these are expensive and they are promoted by advertisement, and they claim that their product is of good quality. Now, chain of markets. Now, we saw the what we saw now, which type of market? Shopping complexes and malls. Now, we are going to see chain of markets. In previous sections, you have read about different markets from where we buy goods. From where do you think shop owners procure their goods? Goods are produced in factories. Procure means obtain their goods. Goods are produced in factories, on farms and in homes. We saw in the video also. However, we don't buy directly from the factory or from the farm, nor would the producers be interested in selling us small quantities such as 1 kilo of vegetables or 1 plastic mug. So, the products are produced in factories. We don't go to the factory and purchase, we go to the shop, and the factory people, they don't sell also, because they want to sell their products in large quantities. So, they don't give us small quantities and we don't go there. The people in between the producer and the final consumer are the traders. The wholesale trader first buys goods in large quantities. For example, the vegetable wholesale trader will not buy a few kilos of vegetables, but will buy in large lots of 25 to 100 kilos. Okay. These will then be sold to other traders in these markets. Buying and selling takes place between traders. It is through these links of traders that goods reach far away places. The trader who finally sells this to the consumer is the retailer. This could be a trader in a weekly market, a hawker in the neighborhood, or a shop in the shopping complex. Now, so in between the producer and the final consumer is a person called trader. The wholesale trader first buys goods in large quantities. They buy in a bulk. Okay. These will then sold to other traders in the markets. Buying and selling takes place between traders. It is through these links of traders that goods reach far away places also. The trader who could finally sells to the consumer is the retailer. Okay. We can understand this with the help of the following examples. So, now we will stop this lesson here. In the next session, we are going to continue with the same lesson. So, read the lesson, whatever we have learnt now, up till now. So, in the next session, we will continue. Okay. Take care. Bye.